Hi friends, it's Scott Giroux, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a web API in Visual Studio, deploy it directly into the Power Platform, and then debug it locally. It's pretty amazing stuff. It's just been announced, and I am about low code as well as pro code, so I always love these kind of features that bring the two together. So stay tuned. Well, sometimes, of course, you've pushed the Power Platform to its limits and you need to create some custom code and deploy it to Azure. Well, of course, the Power Platform has custom connectors that allow us to do just that. And so typically what we would do is we would create a web API project in Visual Studio, and then we could then deploy that into our Azure subscription. Then we maybe configure Azure API management and then maybe extract that schema and create a custom connector from that. This new announcement has just made it even easier, especially when you're just starting to create that custom connector for the first time. And so what we're doing is we're then opening up Visual Studio and creating our web API and then just simply deploying it directly into the Power Platform and creating that custom connector automatically. The other thing is that sometimes you find that there is a problem that happens only when you're calling it via a Power App. And the challenge is that that's all happening in the cloud, right? So it's very difficult to debug that. Well, what we can do now is we can use a feature called Visual Studio Dev Tunnels. And what this does is it creates this connection between the Azure tenant and or our local host, i.e. when we're running the web API locally on our machine. And so that when the custom connector invokes that web service, then it then calls our local host. And so we can then set breakpoints and we can debug it. And so that means that when we run our Canvas app or our flow, we can then see those breakpoints being hit. We can see what the problem is. We can see what our service is returning. It's really fantastic and it increases the efficiency. It speeds up your development tremendously. Okay, so here I am in a development environment and you can have three of these for free, which is fantastic. And of course, this is where the story begins when you're starting on a new feature. So I've got nothing in my custom connectors here. And this is where you would normally previously go in and you would import from an Azure service or you'd import from an OpenAPI file. And if we go over into our Visual Studio here, and what we can do now is we can go and create a new project. What this enables us to do is to select a web API project. Let's call this weather because the weather it's just basically creates a random set of weather forecasts. And that's just the standard template. So if we open up the program here, we'll be able to see its template and, you know, it's not doing anything particularly interesting here. You can see, there we go, just a random set of temperatures. The point is that once you've created that functionality, I can run this and what it will do is it will start up a local host version of my web API. So I can test it because it's running in local host. It means that I can set breakpoints, etc. So if I put a breakpoint here, what will happen now is if we look at the window that it's opened, there's the Swagger definition and I can click try it out and I can say execute. And if we go over to our Visual Studio, there we go. It's hit that particular breakpoint. If we go over back to our Swagger definition there, testing, you can see there's all of the random temperatures of scorching, for example, which is, I'd prefer that at the moment. And so if we go back to Visual Studio and remove that. Now, this is where obviously you would normally have to go and deploy this into Azure. But this is where the fun really starts, because if I could head over into connected services here, I can actually access it from the home page here. So you can see here you've got connected services. I select that and I go and add a new service dependency. What this gives us is the ability now to select the Power Platform. And this is the new functionality that's only in the preview. So if I go next, it now allows me to select my Azure tenant, my Power Platform tenant as well. And I can then select the name for the custom connector I want. Down at the bottom here, we've got the ability to select which particular dev tunnel you want to use. And this is this functionality that exists in Azure that allows me to link from a public URL or an Azure accessible URL, if you've got some authentication against it, directly into my local host. Now, I've already created one. There we go, dev tunnel. So I'm going to go finish, and that will set everything up. And now, if I close that and I run this, so there's our dev tunnel. It's been created, a public URL, and this is existing inside the Azure hosting. And what that means is that when I click continue here, it will now allow that tunnel to access my local machine. And so I can go and test this. If I go back into Visual Studio and set another breakpoint in my program and go, let's go set it again here and go back into our tester here and try it out and execute. Although this is a public URL, you can see it's tunneling through into our local host, which is pretty cool already. But you can see where this is going, right? Now, if we look here at our custom connectors, if you remember previously, we had no custom connectors. Now, if I refresh this page, what we'll see now is that it has deployed our custom connector directly from Visual Studio. So there we have it. You can see there's our weather connector. And if we go into the definition of this connector, you can see that there's nothing in the base URL. Because of course, what it's doing is the Power Platform is using the dev tunnel instead of some API management URL. And in order to test this, I would need to go and create a connection. So I go new connection, like I would do in any other situation. So there's our connection. And if we go back to the custom connectors and go and test it again, go back to test. And if we go and set a breakpoint inside our Visual Studio, this is where it's really starting to hot up. If I click test operation here and head over to Visual Studio, you can see there directly the breakpoint's been hit. And so that's the PowerApps cloud now connecting directly to my local machine. And so if there was something happening that only happened when a citizen developer was using my custom connector, I can start to debug it. Of course, even though we've deployed this directly from Visual Studio, if you wanted to, you could just swap out your API management URL for a dev tunnel URL as well to sort of do, you know, on the fly debugging of this kind of thing, which I think is really, really cool, especially from a developer perspective. So let's see that in action, calling our custom connector from a Canvas app and then debugging it inside Visual Studio. Well, the PAC CLI, which is the Power Platform command line interface, gives us a really cool facility, which is PAC Canvas Create. And if we look at the parameters for that, you'll see that we can provide a connector ID and we'll see the environment, and it will create an app for us, which is pretty cool. So let's go back into the Power Platform here and let's go and create a solution. And I'm going to go and create something called a connector. So let's call it the weather app solution. So I've got that, I go create. And so we can add in the custom connector that we've just created, deployed directly from inside Visual Studio. Of course, it's outside Dataverse, so we'll add it in. So if we head back over to VS Code and we say pack connector list, this gives us all of the connectors in the environment. I've already authenticated against that particular development environment. And we'll see now the newly created custom connector that we added to the solution. So there we go, there we have it. And that was the one that was directly deployed from Visual Studio. So it's just so much easier. Now we'll use our pack canvas operation here to go and create a new canvas app directly from this connector. So if we say pack canvas create help, see what parameters we need to provide. And so we can see that we need to provide the MS app and we also need to provide the connector ID. So let's do that now. So there's the connector ID. If we run this command, so we're saying pack canvas create, giving it the name of the app and then the connector ID of the one that's been deployed. And there it's created our weather. And all that remains now is for us to import that into Power Apps. So there's our MS app that we've created. If I open that inside Power Apps, lovely. We've got our app that's been created with all the different screens, and there's our get weather forecast screen. But if you notice, we've got all these different crosses, which is because we need to add in the reference to our connector. So I'll select that. And there we go. And all those issues have then resolved themselves. So if I go back to the first screen and then run this, I can say get weather forecast and run get. And there we go. So we've got all these different weather forecasts. Now, if I deployed this into Azure, that would be all great. It would be invoking that inside the Azure app service. But because this is running as a custom connector that's linked to our dev tunnel, remember, this is still running, we can set a breakpoint again. So say, for example, we had a problem where if something wasn't working, or we just simply wanted to debug it as an app, I can click get here. If we go over to our Visual Studio, there we go. It's hit our breakpoint. And that, to me, is just pretty awesome, I think. So there we have it. Hope you enjoyed that. It's these kind of features that really get me excited, which is about Fusion development, but also accelerating the pro code development to then augment that low code development environment. If you really enjoyed this, please subscribe to my channel and do let me know in the comments what you think of it and how you think perhaps it could be improved and any new features you'd like to see inside Visual Studio. But until next time, friends, cheers.